All right, in this video, we will go over an ammeter, which is used to measure current. In the previous video, we covered a voltmeter, which is used to measure voltage. Again, in reality, in practice, in a lab course, you are probably going to have a multimeter, which has different functions to measure voltage, current, and resistance. But in terms of the model we use in a circuit diagram, we use different symbols. So in this video, we will specifically be talking about the ammeter. So to measure current, and again, we will use our voltage divider circuit as an example, where we have two resistors, R1 and R2, with some current I through them, and I would like to measure the current in this circuit, I need to insert the ammeter in series with one of the components. So this is something that usually trips students up when working with a breadboard in lab, because to do that, you actually need to break the circuit at some point, so physically move two of the wires so you can insert the ammeter like this, so it is in series and it measures the same current. Now note that in this case, since all three of these components are in series, it doesn't actually matter where I put the ammeter in the circuit. I could have put it up here before the first resistor. I could have put it after the second resistor between that resistor and ground, but all of these parts are in series, so I would measure the same current in each case. Now, in the ideal case, we would like to think that the resistance of the ammeter is zero. So say Rm equals zero, meaning when you put it in series, it doesn't add any resistance to your circuit or cause the current to drop at all. And of course, in reality, that's not true. The ammeter is going to have some non-zero resistance, Rm, to it. So when you put it in series with other things, you're adding more resistance, and you're going to slightly decrease the amount of current flowing through the circuit. So ideally, this Rm is very, very small, and it's not going to affect the readings very much, but just like with the voltmeter we covered in the previous video, again, you do actually have to account for this. For example, if you're comparing theoretical values to measured values and they don't match up exactly, this can be part of the reason. Now, when you go to look up a spec for this, if you're actually looking at a data sheet for the multimeter, unlike for the voltmeter, where you will find a rating for the input resistance or input impedance, which is a term we haven't discussed yet, which again is going to be somewhere in the 1 to 10 mega ohm range, you won't find a value for this input resistance for the current measurement setting. Instead, what you will find is something called the burden voltage, which is the voltage drop over this part of the circuit for a given current. So it'll usually be given in some rating like millivolts per milliamp. So if you actually need to look this up for your multimeter, you'll need to go dig through the data sheet and find this value, and then you can calculate the voltage drop here based on the expected current, and then that's going to tell you the actual voltage drop over your circuit that you're measuring, which is going to be your VN minus whatever this burden voltage is. So again, the model is like putting another resistor in series here, but you can also just treat it as a fixed voltage drop, which is going to subtract from your input voltage to the circuit, resulting in a smaller current. And it's important to note that this burden voltage can vary depending on the current setting or range on your multimeter. So if you have a multimeter with a manual dial for selecting, say, 20 microamps, 200 microamps, 20 milliamps, 200 milliamps, and then usually a different port for something like a 10 amp setting. Each one of these may have a different burden voltage, so I've definitely seen this where students are measuring the current through an LED or something, and they get 12.4 milliamps, and then they change to a different range, and all of a sudden the current is 11.9 milliamps, and they ask, hey, I didn't change my circuit at all, why did the current change when I changed to a different multimeter setting? And this is why, because the resistance or burden voltage of these different settings is slightly different, so that sometimes can have a non-negligible effect on your readings when you're measuring especially smaller currents. So we have finally got through covering a lot of the basics, including reviewing things you probably saw in a physics E&M class and some things that you might not have seen there. In the next few videos, we are going to talk about some common misconceptions students might have even after seeing all this material, before moving on to circuits with capacitors.